Podcast.
Tick tock, tick tock, tick tock, tick tock, tick tock. Time to wake up.
I gotta get to work. Oh, am I gonna make it? The boss hates when I'm late. Then again, it's not like business has picked up any. The streets sure are quiet today. Hey, I'm here. Huh? How'd she get in if no one's here yet? Good morning. I'm real sorry. I hope you haven't been waiting long.
Huh?
Oh, right. She needs some water.
Oh, no thanks. A pint. I mean, a cup of coffee, please. Oh, and bring the whole jar of sugar. I'm gonna need it.
Right. That's one cup of joe. And I'll get you one of the big jars. Has nobody made the coffee yet? Come on, get it together, guys. I'm sorry, miss. This might take a while.
Hey, no hurry. Time's not an issue.
Here you go. Sure. Your age, huh?
Hey, don't talk down to me. Listen, last time I checked, little bro, I've been around a few minutes longer than you.
Okay, I get it already. Very sorry. So what's up? I'm all ears.
Well, you don't have to get all sarcastic.
You really are all ears.
What?
Forget it. Solon, have you seen anybody this morning?
Well, yeah, I mean, I'm looking right at you, aren't I? And there's that customer.
What? Ah! Oh, hello!
You didn't even see her? Dude.
Yeah, but... Ah! Look! Come with me right now!
Easy! So it's a quiet morning. Maybe they just...
I mean no one!
Huh?
Lon, have you bumped into anyone today, besides her?
Now that you mention it, I guess not.
And this isn't setting off any alarms?
Well, should it?
You two really don't remember a thing. Huh? What was that? Who are you? If you're from around town, then I don't know you.
But Rain Manners.
You two really don't remember a thing. Would you please just answer my question? You can call me Anna Crow. Anna Crow will work. Okay, well, we woke up to a ghost town this morning. Maybe you know why?
Yes, you're quite alone. But you always have been.
Huh?
This world, it's always been the two of you. A world without time. One that ended when it began.
What? That's the weirdest thing I've heard.
But don't worry. Just because the world ended doesn't mean that it's going anywhere.
You know, I have been checking up on you two.
Until now, you were nothing but blank stares. So imagine my surprise when Lon took my order. What a morning.
Okay. Now you're kind of scaring me.
So, now that you're awake, we've got a story to tell. Which brings us to...
Tama! Right to here!
Who the hog put this thing on my head?
Yeah, I did try to mention it before.
You take it from here. I'll go on ahead and link up a path.
You the goddess!
Huh? Hey! You can't just leave!
Salutations! The name is Tama, and I'm here to help out. Does anyone have any questions?
Wait, I've got tons of questions! Why were you sitting on my head? And how long can a fox even talk?
That's the seriously the first thing on your mind? Now I see why Anna Crow is just about the ready to throw in the towel.
You're not allowed to be confused!
Hey, whoa, take it easy there, Lon.
I thought you were upset,
too! Let's start the over. I'll make us some of the coffee.
Huh? Oh, yes, please.
But I already made some coffee before you got here. How can you just roll with this, Rain?
Chill the owl. You live the much longer.
Yeah, Lon. You shouldn't start out your morning with so much stress.
Oh, would you like some sugar?
3 cubes for you, right, Lon?
Huh?
I'm good with just one.
No.
Okay, I'll have to go and put the coffee on.
But I just said I... You know what? Just give me my dang cup of coffee. Mirage Keepers? Me and Rain?
That's the correct! Those the marks on your arms are proof. You were born to work the miracles!
Miracles? Our arms can... do that?
Dude...
How could you forget? You used to command a whole legion of them! You were masters of them! Powerful living illusions known as mirages! In the fact, even the Pleiad answered to you, and those are the seven strongest mirages of all! With their power, you could have the ruled over all the world!
Oh... So... we could have ruled the world? Because, what, we controlled these mirages?
Well, that's what I've heard.
From who?
What do you mean? In a crow that told me, of course. But enough the reminiscing. I've got to teach you two to use mirages again.
What? How's that?
First off, I'm going to present you with my very own Prismarium.
So what does it do?
With this Prismarium, the mirage inside becomes yours, and you can then make it do the anything and the everything you command. So let's try it right now in glorious combat.
Wait, what? Huh?
Points, also known as AP. You automatically gain a little bit of AP each the time your turn comes around in battle. The amount of AP you need depends on the what you're trying to do, so make sure you use them wisely. Talent? All right, all right. I think I've seen enough for one to tussle.
All right.
Surpassed. No, the mirage could stand up to you.
Dude, seriously?
Dude, but seriously.
It's hard to believe. I'm sure it is. As far as I can tell, you two have lost everything. All the memories and experience you've ever accumulated. Oh, but wait. Of course that would have happened when you and this world were spliced out.
Huh? So not only did they lose the mirages they had, they've been stripped of all their memories of the mirages too? But, I guess that explains why all their other memories seem to be largely unaffected.
What? Listen, let me show you something. There, just beyond this light, lies another world called Grimoire. That is where you'll find all the mirages you've lost.
You mean they're all inside this gate?
You got it. Are you ready to conquer them again?
So, if we do manage to find all the lost mirages, does that mean we'll be able to remember the things we forgot?
Well, I don't know about that. After all, you lost your memories. It's not the same thing as forgetting them.
Oh.
But, even if you don't remember Grimoire, Grimoire still knows a lot about you. You're certain to find traces and records of your past.
Okay. So, like...
You're saying, whether we remember anything about ourselves or not, we can still find clues about our past and the things we've done?
Correct. And if you keep on gathering mirages, I think you might even meet your family in due time.
Our family?
Huh? Well, I guess. It does make sense that we'd have parents.
Oh, yes. So then, you going? You going? Will you journey to Grimoire? Chapter 1. Land of the Lilikin.
So, this must be Grimoire. What?
She can do stuff like that?
That is awesomely weird.
Well, this kind of works out. We won't have anybody gawking at our arms.
Way to find the silver lining. I guess we should head straight down this path?
It's the only direction we can go. I think you can manage to...
Oh, hello. I spy another mirage.
That is the call to Choco Chin. What are you the waiting for? Go on and imprison the it.
Okay.
Sort of like a prismarium. What is it?
That's the call to prism. Use it to make the Choco Chicks prismarium. Every time you find a new the mirage you haven't seen before, it'll be recorded in Enna Crow's special mirage manual.
Whoa! Does it even have pictures?
You the betcha. And then whenever you add a new mirage to the manual, you receive one of its prisms. But only the first time, mind you. Okay, first, try the weakening the Choco Chick, then they use your prism.
To the claim that mirage for your own.
Go on! The select the imprism command! You might have to try different things before certain mirages will let down their guard and they give you a chance to imprism them. Think the outside of the box.
Chick is inside the Prismarium. It's yours to the keep.
Predictable.
Choco Chick running around in the Prismarium.
Pretty the neat, huh? Next, why the don't you have a go at stacking that Choco Chick on your head? Here, watch, I'll just show you.
Oh, now I get it. So when I saw you perched on Lon's head back in Ninewood Hills, that's what you call stacking.
Yep, that's the right. While I'm up to here, I get to take it nice and easy.
Is that stacking or slacking?
When you create a stack, the HP of everyone in the stack gets the added together. Like they say, strengthen the numbers.
Oh, so it's like combining into a super robot.
Better than yet, your magic and other abilities have the potential to change too. It all depends on how your stack is configured.
Huh? Oh, I don't need any action figures when I get to blast out super attacks like a super robot.
Well, just be the careful. Stacking doesn't make you invincible. Some of the enemy attacks have the power to unstack you.
In other words, bye-bye super robot, so to speak.
Yowzers. It does sound like bad news.
It's true that we are individually the weaker when we're unstacked, but look on the bright side. Since we each get our own the turn in battle, we can use the extra moves to have one member attack and another the heal. It can be very the helpful. Depending on the situation, you might even decide to unstack yourselves by choice. Think the carefully, and choose the best setup for the job. By the way, you two can just switch between giant size and Lilikin size. Depending on your size, you can make different stacks. You won't be allowed to put big things on top of the small things when creating a stack. So, to get on top of a Mirage, you need to be in Lilikin form. The best way to learn is to try it once you've rounded up a few more Mirages. You'll pick it up in no time.
Huh? A dead end?
But there's nowhere else to go. What are we gonna do?
Never the fear! Look the closely! This may appear to be a wall, but it's actually a gimme golem.
Is this a mirage too?
Not in the traditional sense of the word. But you'll see these pests all over Grimoire. And unless you give them what they want, they'll give you a hard time and block the way.
So what is it they want?
It really depends on the gimme golem. So the first thing you'll have to do is examine it.
Gimme, gimme! gimme!
So where do we find that?
That Choco chick you just imprisoned ought to be able to track the down what we need. But first things the first, you're going to have to unlock the right ability on the Choco chick's the Mirage board.
The Choco chicks come along for a stroll.
Huh? It found something.
Yay! Yuda found it! Now, try examining the Gimme Golem one more at a time.
Vanished.
That's so cool. I guess the Choco chick found us just the item we needed.
Yep, yep. With the help of a Mirage or the two, there's nothing that you can't accomplish. And Mirage boards are for much the more than unlocking abilities. You can also use them to change your Mirages into new and the powerful forms. So be sure to keep on the leveling up and working on your Mirage boards. Pretty soon, you'll be bouncing and the trouncing across Grimmore like a pair of the pros!
So, Tama, I noticed Mirages disappear when we defeat them. Why is that?
Most of them... And so, when one of you guys gives them the old KO, they can't maintain their presence here anymore. They fizzle that out and go back to their own worlds.
Huh. Wait. Now, that's weird. Who was it that told me all this before? Ugh. It's like, right there, on the tip of my tongue.
Now what's this?
This is the Cauda Merc Rift. Inside you're the likely to find Mirages that are, shall we
Mirages?
Say...
Oh man, let's go catch them! This one's not very cute.
Mon! Why did you... Now what do we do?
I tried to tell you. Inside Murkriffs, you're likely to find Mirages that are the strong and dangerous.
You tried to tell us. Try a little harder, please!
Ugh.
no. Did you two die already?
What? I died? But that's... no way.
Maybe it's true. That mirage in the Merc Rift did kinda...
Well, I'm still alive.
Yes. That's because someone intervened. Right at the moment of your demise. And made it so the battle never happened.
Wow, you can really do that?
Of course. Although Tama's the one who does it.
That's the right! I have the power to rewind time a little, and then to whisk you to safety. Although, it cost me a life to do it, so I hope you don't mind if I rest for a little the while afterwards.
A life?
You might not believe it, but I've actually got multiple lives. Back there, I had to sacrifice one of those lives to turn back time and to save you. You see, this girl with the ribbon that showed up in my dreams, she's the one who taught me how to do it.
That makes zero sense and kind of freaks me out, but Tama, I'm impressed.
Thanks! Oh, but just so you know, I can only use my powers to protect the two of you specifically. And only if you lose a fight, like what happened to you in the Merc Rift. And I can always recover my lives if you stay here and let me rest a spell. So, don't forget to give me a breather before I run out of second the chances.
Dude, you got it. Say no more. Rest yourself silly.
Yes, sir!
Thanks, Tama. We really owe you one. Especially Lon, who didn't have the good sense to listen before diving in.
Hey, who's that?
Oh, if you mean our new guest, she claims to have gotten herself lost. Go say hello. She's quite the character.
Okay.
The real question is how she got here from the outside world when it's no easy trick. She must have experience crossing between planes.
Would you all slow down?